Hello again. Welcome back to Let's Play IL-2 Sturmovik Cliffs of Dover. I am the Winter Owl, sometimes known as the White Owl, sometimes known as Matt. That's my real name. You can call me that if you want. And hey, we're rotating in place again. Still in our Tiger Moth, which I think is a really cool looking airplane. I'm actually skipping ahead one mission here. This is actually mission 3 in the campaign. Mission 2 was pretty much identical to the first one, just more training in the Tiger Moth, no really specific goals. So I don't think we need to do that one again for the purposes of the Let's Play. Alright, let's go here. Is this all set up? Let's try this. I'm not probably going to do some time compression and or editing. Almost got excited. I almost thought that I had it the first try that time. Alright, maybe I had a little bit too much mixture, a little bit too much throttle that time. I really do love this airplane. I really do. I like it that it's kind of a pain to get started. Yeah, okay, I think we're probably going to be do some editing here because, I don't know, however entertaining it may have been the first time around fighting and struggling with this beast. Yeah, it's, we probably don't want to spend the entire video doing this, do we? Okay, we're started, we're warming up, the engine is starting to get there, so we'll be back. Alright, so what is the goal here for this training mission? We're doing a little bit of cross-country flight here. We're still starting at Upavon. The goal for this, this is our final training flight before we graduate to advanced flight training in the Spitfire. We're going to depart Upavon right here. We're going to head south down to the town of Amesbury. Once we get to Amesbury, a couple of miles west Amesbury, Stonehenge, very helpfully marked on the map. We want to go there and just do some sightseeing. We're going to take a look at Stonehenge, fly around it a couple times, and then return back to Upavon, and we're going to land. And yeah, that'll be it. That'll be our training in this beautiful Tiger Moth. It really does look cool. I like it. Okay, so let's see, is the engine warmed up enough? Let's do a little bit of a control check here, make certain to see it's moving the rudder pedals and everything. Not quite warmed up enough. Let's do some time compression here. Got time running about 4 times normal speed at the moment. I'm watching that RPM gauge. You know what, I never did set my compass here, even though I don't really think I'm going to be using it. Whoa, that's right, time compression. Yeah, it's kind of twitchy, isn't it? Alright, let's go back to normal time. Are we warm enough yet? Oh, there we go. Okay, let's not quite do the whole off-roading thing this time. Let's go over here instead. I still can't turn around and really get over to that runway, but I think I can do this and keep us more or less on my aerodrome, on my airfield. Let's just bump those wheels back down on the ground once. See, I've got this bug here. You can hear the wheels rolling, even though I'm flying. This is an irritating audio bug in this game, but it's easily corrected. No more audio bug. All right, hey trees! Look out for those trees. Woo! That was fun, wasn't it? Yeah, the trees in this game. Okay, they're different from the original, IL-2 1946. Here, let's go to this camera view. Let's pull back some. That's better, isn't it? And there's the river, right up there. Yeah, the original IL-2 1946 had some really annoying trees in that whenever you're down low at treetop level, the way the trees are rendered, you couldn't really see them. They're half invisible, and their collision models extended far beyond the actual visible structure of the tree. So whenever you got down flying on the dirt, you kept on running into and exploding on all these invisible trees, and that was really kind of irritating. This game, the trees aren't so great. They've got the opposite problem. You can see them just fine, but there are no collision models, so you can just fly straight through them. All these trees are just phantom trees. Then the shadows kind of glitch some. Oh well. So, yeah, we're not going to pretend that the game is perfect. Still, I think it looks pretty cool. Alrighty, so here we are. We just departed Upavon, and here's this little town. That is East Chisenberry, which we're passing just over. I'm going to keep on, and it's further to the south from East Chisenberry. There's Netheravon. I'm just going to not be so uptight about getting the pronunciations wrong, especially once we eventually get across the channel, because I don't speak a single damn word of French, and I don't know the pronunciation rules, so I will just mercilessly butcher every single name across the channel, and we'll just have to deal with it. That over there, off the left wing, that's this. Hang on, where'd it go? Oh, that's already to Netheravon. Yeah, we're already to Netheravon. See? That is that other airfield. So I was further south than I thought. Yeah, somebody was asking about in one of the comments. I have the track IR is what I do to look around. You don't know what that is. Little gizmo. I wear a ball cap and I got these reflector gizmo attached to the ball cap, and got a thing kind of like a webcam. It sits on top of my monitor, so it keeps track of what direction my head is pointed. Head tracking. So you can look around with having your hands free. I need to try to learn to be a little more stable, not quite so twitchy all the time when I'm looking around. Okay, so here's some oxbows in this river. I bet you it's these oxbows, and you see the little kind of island or some dirt in the middle of it. Further south of the oxbows, we have the town of Amesbury. See a whole bunch of buildings. There is Amesbury. For a long time, I was really dependent upon the map mode where it charts out all of the it acts like a radar and a GPS all rolled into one. It tells you exactly where other airplanes are. It gives you the line. Tells you exactly what course you're supposed to follow in order to hit the checkpoints for your various missions, but eventually broke that habit. What is this other airfield? That is Buscombe Down, over there, to the left. Alright, so once I hit Amesbury, I'm supposed to head west. Let's go find Stonehenge. There's a windmill out there, which is kind of cool, I guess. Right, so here's this oxbow, which is just north of Amesbury, and this points more or less towards Stonehenge up here. I actually need to be a little bit north of it. It feels good to get rid of the crutch of all the extra information on that map.